This is the continuation of second module, milling. Some of the different types of milling machines are horizontal milling machine, which is also called as knee and column type milling machine. The following are the parts of this horizontal milling machine: base, elevating screw, knee elevating handle, cross feed handle, saddle, front brace, arbor support, cone pulley, telescopic feed shaft. For general shop work, the most commonly used is the column and knee type, where the table is mounted on the vertical slides of the main column. The knee is vertically adjustable on the column so that the table can be moved up and down to accommodate work of various heights. These machines are classified according to the various methods of supplying power to the table, different movements of the table, and different axis of rotation of the main spindle. This is the second one, vertical milling machine. Some of the parts of this type of vertical milling machine are base, saddle, table, spindle head, and column. The position of the spindle is vertical or perpendicular to the work table. The spindle head, which is clamped to the vertical column, may be swiveled at an angle, permitting the milling cutter mounted on the spindle to work on angular surfaces. Spindles can also be adjusted up or down relative to the work. The machine is adapted for machining grooves, slots, and flat surfaces. The end mills and face milling cutters are the usual tools mounted on the spindle. Next type of machine is called as the boring machine. The first one is the horizontal boring machine. As you can see from the diagram, there are different parts like headstock, pulley for counterbalancing weight of headstock, headstock elevating screw, boring head, boring cutter on boring bar, work, end supporting column, bearing block, saddle, cross slide, and table. The work is supported on a table which is stationary, and the tool revolves in a horizontal axis. A horizontal boring machine can perform boring, reaming, turning, threading, facing, milling, and many other operations with suitable tools. Work pieces which are heavy, irregular, unsymmetrical, or bulky can be conveniently held and machined. This is the second one, vertical boring machine. The following are the parts of this boring machine: feed adjusting levers, toolbox, tool head assembly, ram, housing, hand wheel for ram adjustment, cross rail, fine hand adjustment for ram, cross rail elevating screw, table, and bed. The work rotates on a horizontal table about a vertical axis, and the tool is stationary except for the feed. The machine may be looked upon as a vertical lathe with its headstock resting on the floor and its large faceplate or chuck lying in a horizontal plane. The major advantage is that large diameter and heavy workpieces similar to checking jobs on a lathe may be set up more conveniently and quickly than on a lathe. The other type of machine is called as the broaching. In this method of removing metal by pushing or pulling a cutting tool called a broach, which cuts in fixed paths. Surfaces finished by broaching may be flat or contoured. Process is limited to the removal of about 6 mm of stock or less. Following are the different types of broaching machines. First one is the horizontal broaching machine, which is having pulling head, broach, and work fixture. Most of the horizontal machines are of pull type. These are used for either internal or external broaching, although internal work is the most common. It consists of a bed or a base a little more than twice the length of the broaching stroke. These machines are used primarily for broaching keyways, slots, round holes, etc. They have the disadvantage of occupying more floor space. Next is the vertical broaching machine, which is having a column, broach, fixture, and table, work, and base. The vertical types may be obtained in either push or pull type. The push type is the most popular. Vertical machines require an operator platform or a pit and are economical of floor space than the horizontal type. The modern vertical broaches are offered with both hydraulic and electromechanical drives, but hydraulic drives are the most common because they cost less. Third one is the continuous broaching machine. which is having broach, a support, two components, loading and unloading, support and the fixtures. These machines may have a rotary work table or a horizontal conveyor type arrangement. In this case, the operation is continuous because workpieces can be loaded and unloaded without stopping the machine. The broaches or broach segments are held stationary while the workpieces are continuously passed under them.